same that electron microscopy has even structures in magnetic conditions. So the, one of the computers is X-ray, where we see that most of the structures where the flexible regions are there in the wings.
Yes.
So they usually meet that, you know, meet that in X-ray. Do you believe that we can get those flexible regions in cryo, which are not just cryo?
I think that should be possible. See, I mean, this has always been an issue that normally biological molecules don't exist in the form of crystals, right? So that is something that we impose. We purify molecules and then we try to crystallize them in a certain form. And it is sometimes difficult to see flexible regions. So I think that with the ability of cryo-EM to generate high-resolution structures, even with a small number of particles, and with, of course, in-situ structure-solving capability, I think that problem can be addressed in later years. With the amazing progress we're having, I think it's quite possible.
So you talked about the entry costs. So how many cryo-EMs are there currently in India, and what is the meaning, in what way can we reduce the entry cost?
Yeah, that's a very, very good question and very applicable to the Indian context. So right now in India, as I was talking about, you know, what is the state-of-the-art cryo-EM? It's a machine with a 300 kV accelerating voltage, which is equipped with a direct electron detector, an in-column filter, and a phase plate. And a version of that currently in India is only available in Bangalore at INSTEM. And in other parts of it, so a machine with a 200 kV accelerating voltage and a direct electron detector will soon be installed in Regional Center for Biotechnology at RCB in Faridabad. Other than that, there are machines which have reduced capability. In IIT Delhi, we have a 200 kV cryo-electron microscope, which has a CCD camera. Unfortunately, it does not come with a direct detector. Also, in ISAR Trivandrum has a 120 kV machine with cryo capability. There are some other 120 kV machines available. Kolkata IACB has a 300 kV machine, but again, that does not have a direct electron detector. So entry cost, if we want to get a perfectly equipped machine, it comes around 40 to 45 crores, which is a significant expense for you know, a country like ours. So, but, you know, if we have enough screening microscopes, which, because when I talked about, you know, part of cryo-EM is still significantly manual, where one has to work out the freezing conditions and generate good grids, which then can be utilized for data collection. And those processes take up quite a bit of time. So if we have a certain number of screening microscopes, then, you know, the state-of-the-art microscopes can only be used for data collection and not for standardizing freezing conditions per se, which would optimize the time required. And also, India has access to European Synchrotron Radiation Facility, or ESRF, which has cryo-electron microscopes that one can put in a proposal and go and access their machines and collect data. But there also, we are looking into a problem where we don't have enough screening microscopes in the country, which can be used to sort of standardize data collection procedures, generate grids, which can be shipped to these locations for data collection. But if we had enough screening microscopes, I think then this would this problem would to some extent reduce. But I do think that state of the art microscopes are required, more state of the art microscopes are required in our country.